Oxygen! Whoa! It's everywhere. It's doubled and holy moly, will you look at the size of that centipede? What's going on? Well, for those of you that don't know, in the parameters of this particular Life's Biggest Question, the oxygen on Earth has suddenly doubled and we've been reaping the many oxygenated benefits that come with it, as well as the myriad of detriments that would mean our planet is either completely on fire or under threat from giant bugs a few thousand years down the line, of course, so don't worry. But we all know this is hypothetical, so we have to throw our heads together, and like many of you have already done in the comment section of our initial video, there's a few things left behind for debate. So, in that case, let's take a look. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your listening body floating voice, Jack Finch, as once again, we revisit this particular Life's Biggest Question and take a look at what you guys had to say of the question, what if the oxygen on Earth doubled? Roll the clip.
Just bring normal fellas.
Aquarius, please advise on CO2 status.
For the curious amongst you, that clip was from 1995's Apollo 13 because, you know, just breathe normal, fellas. This is a video about oxygen, and as many of you pointed out in the initial response to this Life's Biggest Question, for some strange reason, watching a video about oxygen suddenly makes you frighteningly aware about your own breathing pattern. And now you're doing it again, right? Yeah, sorry. Anyway, back to the video, because as many of you may have noticed, this is a new thing that we're trying out on Life's Biggest Questions, where some of the more dynamic videos get a more precise look to shake things up a little bit and see if there are any points that we missed on first viewing. Thankfully for us, there are a boatload of intriguing insights to sift through, but if you'd like some context as to what the hell we're talking about, then please, now would probably be high time to check out our What If the Oxygen on Earth Doubled video, because, yeah, this won't really make any sense if you don't. Hey, we're just being diligent. In our first video, we spoke about the massive plethora of things that would go really, really wrong if the oxygen on Earth doubled, which mainly harkened back to the Paleozoic era of Earth's ancient history, where the oxygen on Earth was indeed double, and giant lizards and insects roamed the planet in their overwhelming O2-rich environment. Which leads us neatly to our first comment, which comes from Siani31, who says, "If you really think about it though, everyone is freaking out about gigantic bugs, but in reality, they could only live outside. Most bugs are just small enough to fit in tiny holes in our houses, so if they were all large, we would really have no issues in our house. Until you step outside." Yeah, exactly, until you step outside. Dun dun dun! I mean, okay, this is a pretty interesting outlook on things, one of which has been disseminated in the many classic sci-fi creature feature horror movies of old. The deadly mantis, the black scorpion, tarantula, all of which are actual classic staples of horror cinema, but all of which paint a much more dramatic landscape than what would happen under the parameters of the oxygen on Earth doubling. You see, as we laid out in our initial video, during the Paleozoic era, where 6-foot centipedes and dragonflies the size of hawks roamed the oxygen-rich wild, those massive creatures had already had hundreds of thousands of years to grow to their staggering size from the tiny amoebas that spawned their evolutionary cycle, as did every other insect, lizard, and mammal that followed them. You see, unfortunately, in this hypothetical scenario, evolution takes time, and under the parameters of our new simulated Earth, it would take a staggering amount of time for the planet's ecosystem to become fully engorged on the oxygen-rich environment and grow to their gigantic size. Which, in one way, you're kind of right about. They wouldn't have to worry about pestering us in our homes because, in all likelihood, we wouldn't have homes, given the fact that the human population would have more than likely succumbed to the many negatives of an oxygen-rich environment and would all be, well, long gone. If we did somehow survive, though, yeah, you're bang on the money. Sharpen me some spears, we've got giant centipedes to hunt. Oh, you brave people. Next up, JennyBean06 says, "So if we keep destroying the forest so there's half of the oxygen, we would live longer." Okay, where do we even begin with this one? In short, no. No, not at all. That's not how it works. In fact, with less oxygen on the planet, we'd all die pretty quickly. That goes without saying. Now, although that does go without saying, not immediately, because if our 21% oxygen atmosphere depleted in half to 10.5% oxygen, there'd still be breathing room, but we'd struggle to survive. Now, thankfully for us, that isn't how our atmosphere works anyway, and atoms can't just vanish willy-nilly, but if we destroyed our planet's forests to the point where the oxygen on Earth slashed in half, whew, holy moly, we're in too deep, and it's time to build a rocket to Mars, because we'd probably have a better chance of breathing air on there. Our forests and every single tree on this planet are integral to maintaining our delicate atmosphere, and keeping it in the sweet spot that means all life on planet Earth can survive and thrive. Deforestation is one of many key factors in the climate emergency that our civilization now faces. And even more worryingly, one of the most important rainforests on the planet, the Amazon, is increasingly under threat of being removed. So, no. Please don't get rid of the forest. And that leads us to our next comment. Ali Buzz says, think of the Amazon rainforest where the oxygen is almost 10 times more. All of the wildlife there is so diverse and evolved to a point where we can't even keep up anymore. Crazy. And yeah, that is an incredibly important point, Ali, although you are slightly mistaken in the fact that the Amazon rainforest doesn't exactly produce 10 times more the amount of oxygen, which would be insane. And anyone that strolled into the Amazon would suddenly become a superhuman before collapsing from oxygen poisoning. But the fact remains the same. The Amazon rainforest is staggeringly important to the oxygen production on Earth, given the fact that it produces around 20% of the planet's oxygen, and even the slightest of disruption to that process, as in the Brazilian government tearing it down to make way for economic growth, will have dire consequences. However, the health of the rainforest isn't just down to the oxygen it produces, but more importantly, its vital role is in its responsibility as a carbon sink. You see, any forest, especially tropical rainforests, act as carbon sinks, absorbing the abundance of carbon dioxide that our planet now produces. Getting rid of that in any capacity, yeah, you can see that's really, really bad. More importantly than that, though, although the Amazon produces 20% worth of the world's oxygen, the most important facet to that is our oceans, which face a similar threat to the rainforest. About 70% of our planet's oxygen is produced by tiny, microscopic, photosynthetic organisms that float in the oceans, called diatoms, which are a sort of phytoplankton. Essentially, these guys are algae, and they're so important to the delicate balance of our oxygen supply that if they go, we all go. And currently, the acidification of the oceans are making it pretty difficult for these guys to stay alive. So, yeah, let's not worry about giant centipedes for the moment. Let's worry about that stuff. Well, there we have it, guys. Our second glance at the question, what if the oxygen on Earth doubled? There are a few more things to worry about before we face that hypothetical notion. So, yeah, let's face them. What do you guys think? Do you agree? Have any more to add to this? Please let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, and we'll be seeing you in the next one. Before we depart from today's video, if you'd like to continue on with your questioning binge, then please feel free to hit that playlist floating conveniently to the side, and we'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.